everyone. It's Joe and Mike with Live It Up Ogden. We are at the Terrace Plaza Playhouse. We're going to watch Curtains and...
And we're going to talk to the people behind the scenes. We're going to talk to the lighting people, everything, that, and find out what goes on to put a production like this together. It's great to have something like the Terrace Plaza Playhouse and have top-notch productions here in our own community.
I'm here with Shelby, and tell us everything you do here. You're sort of a jack of all trades. So.
Yeah, I'm involved with a lot of things here at the Playhouse. I do graphic design for our posters and programs. I've directed here and designed scenery for the Playhouse, and I also perform frequently in productions as well.
And he's performing this evening in Curtains. And we wanted to talk a little bit about what this Playhouse brings to the community.
Yeah, it's really a great opportunity for me to be part of this Playhouse. It's like a little family here. It's a family-run Playhouse. And the people that are involved in the shows here, a lot of us have done a number of shows over the years and in different capacities. And so we get to be very close to each other. There's a really positive energy, I think, when you come through the door.
I totally agree with you, Shelby. We just walked into the stage area, and it is just an intimate, cool feeling in there.
So during the show, what are you doing up here?
Usually I'm up here running the sound and mixing the microphones, making it sound balanced with the music and how they're projecting and talking on stage. That's usually what I do during the show. The light cues are written prehand or beforehand, and they basically, once they're written, the operator just pushes the button as they go through.
And so it just automatically kind of happens.
Yeah, they're pre-programmed in there and it takes care of it. So after that point, it's really more, the sound is the more hands-on portion of it.
Gotcha. And do you ever have issues where it just starts going bad and you have to fix it?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah, there's times when the microphones will just quit working on stage. We'll have a short in them or something like that. So we have to make a quick change or a quick fix.
Leslie, you directed this show, correct?
That's right.
Okay. Tell us about your involvement with Terrace Plaza Playhouse. What else have you done here?
I came here about 18 years ago to audition for a show. And I ended up getting the lead in Annie, well, not as Annie, but as the secretary, lead. And I've been stuck here ever since.
That is great.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Did you ever imagine that you'd be here directing a show?
I never even imagined I would make it into the show the very first time, and I got the lead. I was in shock. And then I got the lead, and then I did whole shows, and then I started directing and stuff like that. So it's been a lot of fun.
That is fantastic. And tell us about the show we're going to see tonight, Curtains.
Now, this is a new show, and it just got off of Broadway not very long ago. It won a Tony. David Hyde Pierce won the Tony for being the lead in it. And it is such a great show. It's such a great family show and stuff. It's one of those shows that has those big dance numbers, that, like the older musicals that have the big dance numbers, but it's very smartly written. It's very funny. It's got a really funny, clever script to it. And the David Hyde Pierce, the detective part is kind of a quirky detective, kind of like a Columbo, if you remember that kind of era. And so, yeah, he's kind of a funny guy that comes in and who also loves musical theater.
Nice.
So, you know, he comes in, solves the mystery, solves the show.
Tell me, how many plays a year do you guys do?
We do seven.
Seven plays? Mm-hmm. Hey, wonderful. And all year long, or do you take a break?
There's a dark week in between shows to get ready for the next show. We feel we need a full dark week to prepare for the next show, and it's been a good decision for us to make. Have that dark week. It gives us some extra time, and there's a lot of work going into a show, and usually they run about six weeks, and so that last week before you open the show, everything's got to come together.
We finally have a minute to talk to Jackie, who was Carmen Bernstein in Curtains, but she has more of a story here in this place, so tell us about it.
Well, I'm part owner, along with my dad and husband. We run the place here. And as far as the Carmen Bernstein part, well, when there's a nice little part that comes along, I got to jump into it.
That was a perfect part for you, too. I loved it.
It's kind of fun playing the producer when you are the producer.
I loved it. The show people. That's awesome.
That's right. Show people.
I love it. So tell us a little bit more, though, about the family business. This started with your mom, right?
20 years ago was our first season, starting with Christmas Carol, this very Christmas Carol. Mom had a dream to have a theater, and so as a family, we built the theater. We helped keep it going, and as we progressed, the community got more and more involved, and so here we are today, 20 years later.
Yeah, and it's awesome that the community comes out. They participate in the plays themselves as right. actors and actresses, but also they need to come out and support you guys.
We do. We need the community to know that we're here and to come every Monday, Friday, and Saturday night. We're here.
Well, thanks so much, Jackie. It was
Thank you. Such a fun show.
This is a great place, guys. Come check it out.
Come see us. We're always here.
Mike, we finally found our spot in the director's chair.
Did. Had a great time tonight at the Terrace Playhouse watching Curtains.
The lights are out. It's time to go.
Well, let's go.